everyone seated here is indeed very significant. I've got a long list. I'm recognizing batches so we can get the program underway. But before then, permit me to recognize the presence of Architect Ahmed Musa Danjua, MD CEO of Federal Mortgage Bank. He's here with us. Mr. Peter Obaseki, FCIB, is a council member, and the CEO of FCMB Group is also here with us. Also here with us from the regulatory angle is Mrs. Tokuba Martins, FCIB Director, Office of CBN. Please let's appreciate the regulator. Tony Enebeli Huzo. And to just save time, I'd like to request all members of the Governing Council of the Traditional Bankers here present to please stand up and please take a bow. Members of the Governing Council, members of the Governing Council. Please let's celebrate them. That is the special program in the affairs of this institute. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, before I bring off stage the President to deliver his welcome address, permit me to recognize the presence of our second Vice President, Mr. Ken
of FCIB. Honorary National Treasurer, Professor Deji Olariwaju, FCIB. Past President, the beauty of this institute is that our past president, they're always with us. They've shown that. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it gives me a great pleasure to welcome you all to the 2018 edition of the CIBN Annual ONFCIB, former Deputy Governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria and former Head of Global Partnership and Resource Mobilization, World Health Organization in Geneva. Currently, he is a professor of practice in international business and public policy at the Fletcher School of Law and Diplomacy at Tufts University. In the 3 quarters of contraction, there still exists a notable gap towards economic development. For example, the National Bureau of Statistics report that microeconomic indicators such as unemployment rate have steadily risen from 13.9% in the third quarter of 2016 to 18.9%.